What is going on, you guys? It's your girl Diana back at you with another YouTube video. Today I'm going to be going over what I think are going to be some of the most useful Pokemon in order to take down the 7-star Greninja raids. I realize that these were literally announced yesterday and everything is super preliminary, but this should help you start getting together a strategy so that you can take this down as easily as possible. So if you're new here, make sure that you subscribe so that you're always up to date on the latest Pokemon news and give this video a thumbs up so that we can push it out into the YouTube algorithm so that more Pokemon fans can see it. And if you would like another way to support the channel, please feel free to check out the merch store. There is a link down below in the description that takes you to not only my merch store, but also all of my other socials so you can keep up with what I'm doing on a daily basis. But let's go ahead and hop into the raid counters. Okay, so first things first, let's go ahead and go over what exactly we're gonna be going up against in these raids. So normally Greninja is a water dark dual type Pokemon. However, for the raids, it is going to have a poison terra type, so defensively it will be a poison type. And most likely it is going to have the ability Protean, which is the same hidden ability as Mascarada that allows you to switch your Pokemon's type into the type of move that you're about to use once per switch in. It did get nerfed. Some people are speculating that Greninja might get Battle Bond in these raids. So honestly, I'm hoping for the best and hoping that that's not true because that would definitely make things more difficult. So for now, I'm just going to plan around the fact that it will most likely have Protean. And the thing about Greninja is that it can go either way when it comes to the strategy that they plan on using it. It can either be a physical attacker or a special attacker, seeing as it has an attack stat of 95 and a special attack stat of 103. Greninja is also really fast with a speed stat of 122. And seeing as it can really go either way when it comes to physical and special attacks, I have a bad feeling that just to be annoying, they are going to give us a mix of both during the raids. And when it comes to its move set, these are the moves that I think it's most likely to have. So I think it's definitely gonna have Water Shuriken. It's literally Greninja's signature move. And considering that it will be a poison Terra type, I would not be surprised if they put Gunk Shot on it. Also, because I think that they want to be annoying and go for coverage, I can definitely see them putting Ice Punch on it as well as Night Slash to take care of any psychic types. Do you see why these raids might be a little difficult? Its move pool, besides these four moves that I already mentioned, considering that it can learn more than four moves because it is a 7-star raid, is very broad. It can learn things like Acrobatics, Ice Beam, Liquidation, it can learn Sword Dance, Trailblaze. They could throw a Terra Blast on there. There is a ton of different options that they can go with. And so, in order to combat these very complex raids, I've come up with the following Pokemon that I think would work best. Like I said, however, these are super preliminary considering these raids were quite literally announced yesterday. So I would love to hear what Pokemon you're thinking about bringing down below in the comments, because I'm sure there is a ton of great options out there. But the first option that I have here is actually an option that the Pokemon company themselves suggested when they released the information for the Greninja raids, and that would be Lucario. They did also suggest Bronzor, however I like Lucario more, so I went ahead and built a Lucario. So why is Lucario good? Well, for starters, it's half steel, which means it's going to be resistant to any poison type moves. So following that logic, I also went ahead and gave it a steel Terra type. And for my Lucario in particular, I did go for a physical attacking build. And what's cool about Lucario is you can kind of go either way with it. You can either make it a special attacker or you can make it a physical attacker. But me personally, I went with the physical attack build. So for my Eevees, I went ahead and maxed out its HP as well as its attack stat. And for its moveset, I went ahead and gave it Meteor Mash, Iron Defense, Sword Dance, and Screech. And here's my thought process behind this moveset. So Lucario tends to be a little bit squishy, I'm not gonna lie. If you do go with Lucario, you're definitely gonna need some good support Pokemon. But in order to combat that a little bit, I did go ahead and toss Iron Defense on there so that I could beef up its defense a little. I also, of course, gave it Sword Dance so that Meteor Mash can hit even harder. And Screech is there in order to lower Greninja's defense stat. I will say, however, if you are going for a physical build instead of Meteor Mash, you can definitely put Earthquake on there as well. Either one works. So with this moveset, if you are able to set up Iron Defense, Sword Dance, and Screech, all while staying alive, that's why I said you definitely need some support Pokemon, then you should be able to hit it pretty hard. Another option for an offensive Pokemon that I was thinking about bringing is Tinkaton. Now, ideally, you would want to give Tinkaton a Steel Terra type as well. I did not have enough Steel Terra shards because I used them all on Lucario, because Lucario had a Fighting Terra type. But just keep that in mind. I do plan on changing Tinkaton's Terra type into a Steel Terra type before I actually take it into the raids, just for the same reason that Steel is immune to poison. Which means, once again, that if Greninja does use any poison type moves during the raid, Tinkaton will not be able to be poisoned. I went ahead and maxed out its attack stat as well as its HP stat. Unfortunately, Tinkaton, just like Lucario, can be a little bit squishy, so once again, you will definitely need some good support Pokemon if you do plan on bringing Tinkaton. And to move pool-wise, I went with Gigaton Hammer, Light Screen, Reflect, and Sword Dance. So Sword Dance is on there for obvious reasons, to increase my attack stat even more. Gigaton Hammer because it is Tinkaton's hardest hitting move. And then I went ahead and tossed Light Screen and Reflect on it, just to combat whatever moves Greninja might actually be throwing out at us. So when it comes to Lucario and Tinkaton, they're definitely just going to be hard hitters that you're going to want to keep alive, so that you can try to do as much damage in one hit as possible before any of the stats get cleared. Another option that I think could be good would be to bring Clodsire. And what's cool about Clodsire is you can either go the support route or you can go the offensive route. So Clodsire is a poison and ground dual type, which means that one, it's going to resist any poison type moves that Greninja might use, and two, since it can learn ground type moves, it is going to be able to hit Greninja with super effective moves. Another cool thing about Clodsire is its ability Water Absorb. So like I mentioned, Greninja is most likely going to have Water Shuriken on it. If not Water Shuriken, probably some other type of water type move. And what's cool about Water Absorb is that if Clodsire gets hit by any water type moves, it actually absorbs the water type move, and instead of taking damage from it, it actually heals itself. So all around, Clodsire is a pretty solid pick. Now in my case, I went for an offensive Clodsire, and I went ahead and maxed out its attack and its HP stats. And moveset wise, I gave it Earthquake, Acid Spray, Recover, and Curse. So I have Curse on there in order to increase my attack and defense stats. I have Earthquake on there because it's going to be able to hit Greninja for a super effective move. I do have Acid Spray on there, which in retrospect would work better if I did go for a special attacking build. So if anybody has a better suggestion on what move I could put instead of Acid Spray, that would be amazing. Leave it down below in the comments. But I do have Acid Spray on there. And lastly, I have Recover on there so I can last longer in the raids, of course. And if you are going for more of a support Pokemon build, you could definitely switch out the move Curse for something like Helping Hand, and Earthquake for something like Chilling Water. Some other options that I was kind of tinkering with were Umbreon and Gastrodon. I haven't fully EV trained these guys yet because I was still kind of messing around with them and tweaking them, but for Umbreon, I would definitely make it a support Pokemon. And I actually took the advice of one of the members in my Discord channel and gave it the moveset Snarl, Helping Hand, Light Screen, and Reflect. As for Gastrodon, I was thinking about making it an offensive Pokemon, and I was thinking about giving it the moves Mud Slap, Recover, Earth Power, and I was actually still deciding what I wanted to give it for its final move, so leave your suggestions once again down below in the comments. But Gastrodon does have the ability Storm Drain, which is similar to Clodsire's Water Absorb ability. However, instead of healing itself when it gets hit by a water type move, it actually increases its special attack stat. So like I said, I'm definitely still tweaking Gastrodon, and for Umbreon, I do still need to EV train it, but I do think that this is a great move set for Umbreon. I'm just really not too sure about Gastrodon. But I do think that Clodsire, Tinkaton, and Lucario are going to be pretty solid choices for these raids. But let me know what you guys think down below in the comments. I definitely expect these raids to be a little bit tougher than the past few 7-star raids that we've gotten, just because of how wide Greninja's move pool is. But like I said, I would love to hear your suggestions down below in the comments for what Pokemon you think would be best in order to bring to these raids. Hopefully you guys found this video helpful, and as always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Love you guys. Bye.